Yep. Come on, boy. You're okay, boy. Hey. Hold here, boy. Yeah, there you go, boy. Yeah, good boy. Let's get you looking nice. Okay, boy. Let's go.
God, you did it. Praise Jesus. Oh, God. I gotta grab something for the blood. Thank you. Oh, I was done for. You saved me. Thank you. Take something from my back for the trouble, though. I'm gonna take a minute now. My leg feels like it's on fire.
Here, drink this for the pain.
Oh, God, yes. And to think, I almost didn't bring the trap. I'd be dead now, if not for you. I'll be thankful every day that you heard me hollering.
Yep.
Whoa, easy. Yeah, that's it, boy. Easy there. Good job. Okay, boy. There, boy. You're all right, boy. Yeah. Thank you.
easy.
Around. Hey, mister. I just want to be left alone, all right?
A sentiment I'm familiar with. Fair enough, kid.
Holding hands with that dog. Come on, kid. You wait, Lily Mae. Well, someday, I'll show you. I'll be rich, a nice big house. You'll be begging me to court you.
Yeah. All right, boy. Easy. Whoa.
That horse shits in camp.
Calm down. Here.
Hey, listen. I just wanted to say... I know you bastards missed me. Even you, Arthur. Even you. But I'm back home now, so everything's going to be okay. Uncle Sean is back. And don't you worry, Miss Grimshaw, you old crone. I'll keep them girls in line. If I have to whip them, I will.
Did you get a bump on the head?
Nobody needs to.
And don't you worry, Mr. Pearson, you drunk old shitbag. It'll be nothing but the finest game in the pot. Now Deadeye Maguire's back. And don't worry about nothing, Mrs. Grimshaw. We'll have this camp running like clockwork. I love you bastards. Have fun. Have lots of fun.
Sean will make your life hell when he finds out you're an O'Driscoll.
Oh, great.
Just be grateful you're alive.
Uh-oh, here comes trouble.
I can't get rid of you, can I?
All right there.
Did you miss him?
Mind if I join
you? You know, I think I actually did.
I suppose.
You're looking lovely as ever, if I may say so.
Oh, stop it.
Mind yourself, Susan.
I'm all the way from Blackwater to here.
This is stupid.
Something a little more civilized.
Miss O'Shea.
I missed a good excuse to celebrate.
That's the deal.
Never need one of those, Uncle.
That makes you a better man than me, sir.
Real heavy in Blackwater, Dutch. Posters of you and Hosea everywhere, Trelawney said.
All the more reason to stay well away for now.
This stew is decidedly lacking on decent meat, Mr. Morgan. Just make sure it goes into the pot, not your pot. Good job, Mr. Morgan.
How are you?
I've come up with some ideas for ways we could improve things around here if you want to take a look.
Good.
Keep my eye out for some good material.
Oh, that's it. I'm never drinking again.
Herr Morgan! Herr Morgan!
Mr. Strauss?
You busy, my friend?
Why?
I'll cut you in.
Loaning. Already?
You know how it is. People is happy to borrow off someone like me, but more enthusiastic paying back to someone like you.
Of course. Who are they?
Let me see. A Chick Matthews works at Guthrie Farm. He's a hand, I believe. Mr. Roble, the small holder at Painted Sky, runs the operations there badly. Miss Lily Millett is a ranch maid up at Emerald Ranch.
And here was me believing Dutch's bluster about us helping folk.
It's legal work, Mr. Morgan. Debtors belong in prison. We are doing them a favor.
Aye. I'll make sure they see it in them terms.
Put the debts in the deed box and try not to kill them. It's very bad for...
I just miss him so much.
Of course you do. Goes without saying.
What am I gonna do?
You're gonna suffer. And life's gonna go on. That's the truth of it. I won't lie to you. Here with us. Oh, they ain't so bad. It's nasty out there on your own.
I know.
Good boy. Have this, boy. Let's go, boy. Slow up. No.
Well, that's exactly what I've been looking for. Well, hey there, partner. Come take a look at this. Look at this, my friend. Tobacco. Nature's gift to us all. Focuses the mind like nothing else.
Whatever you say.
Well, I say, why buy it off the shelves when you can make your own?
Hmm.
Well, plenty left here if you're interested. I'd best keep moving.
Okay, boy. Knock, knock, Mr. Robo.
No, przepraszam, co pan robi w moim domu?
God damn it. English? Speak English?
Me? Silesia.
Yeah, good
I'll
for you.
I'll bet Silesia.
I'm here for money. You borrow from a German man?
Aha, German. Mein Herr, sprechen das this the Kaiserreich.
I don't speak German neither. I'm here for money. Money that you borrowed from Leopold Strauss.
Leopold Strauss.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So it's time to pay. Where is it?
Well, no, I have nothing. It's very bad winter.
We've all had a bad winter, pal. Where is it?
No. No. Nie.
Now, you remember where you're keeping that silver?
Potrzebuję trochę czasu. Znajdę ci pieniądze.
Oh, still don't understand you. Where is the money? Gold, dollars.
Nie rób tego. I have nothing. No. Please, no. No, have money, but I have this. It's good. It's valuable. It's Warszawa, yes.
I have your things. Okay? I have anything in here or out there?
Yes.
What you got behind there?
So, przepraszam, nie rozumiem.
Move aside. You must have come here with something.
Kusakom nie można ufać. Amerykańcom też.
What do we have here?
Moja obrączka, nie!
Just keep quiet. Longer I look, the madder I get. Don't even speak English. There'll be something somewhere.
No.
Yes. Okay. That should about cover things. Good boy. Boy. Yep. Easy. Down. Whoa, whoa! See? Okay there.
You there. Would you be interested in some friendly competition? I've come all the way north from Mexico to challenge a real American gunslinger. You him?
Gunslinger? Let's find out.
Okay, man. That's what I like to hear. Look, man, rules are simple, okay? Whoever shoots more of these bottles wins. The range needs to be clear before we begin, amigo. Hey, man, you should do something. That's all.
Easy now. There, boy. Easy, boy. You're okay. Pretty good. Howdy.
You just
calm down, will you? take care now.
Come home, please.
You dumb shit.
Is it? Okay, boy. Let's go.
Good God, buddy!
Whoa, easy. It's all right, boy. Come on, boy. You're all right, boy. Yeah. Slow it up. Easy. Easy, boy. Gotta be done. Just give me a minute, boy. Yeah. there, boy. Yeah. Eat this, boy. Yeah. You Chick Matthews?
Oh, no, no, not me, sir. That's the greenhorn over there. Oh, and there he goes.
So long, long shark.
Damn it! Hey! Get back here! You owe us money! Go! Last chance to save your hide! Stop!
You got the map. Do the decent thing. I knew I shouldn't have borrowed.
Slow up now. Wait, boy. What? Yep. Easy, whoa. Thank you. Come on now, boy. Easy.
Why's it always gotta be such a goddamn performance with you? Now, I told you I'd get you the money next week, and I'll get it.
If you didn't make it this week, who's to say you'll make it next?
Don't you take...
Lily! Where's our money?
What?
That loan you took. It's payday.
I'm sorry. I don't have it right now.
Well, then. I guess we got a big problem, don't we?
Cooper! Give him what you've got.
I ain't giving him nothing except a lesson in damn manners!
Son of a bitch!
Leave me alone, won't you? You
I didn't steal that. It's a debt. Oh, damn it.
Can a man have some peace?
Maybe you should think about the kinds of men you're friendly with, miss.
You've got your money. I don't have to listen to your wisdom, all right? So long. What do you want? I've got nothing to say to you.
Yep. Doing good, girl. That's a good girl.
Who's that?
Coming in.
Wondered when you'd roll back in.
Yeah.
I apologize in advance for this stew. It needs better meat. Thank you. Just in time, Mr. Morgan. Many thanks, Mr. Morgan. Oh, Mr. Morgan! I've jotted down a few things that I think could be nice additions around here. I reckon I need to get my hands on some material first.
Whiskey, like waves on the Bay of Biscay, I began to tumble.
Not now, Lenny.
Good to hear. How did you get on, Herr Morgan?
Fine. Our accounts are up to date. Sad sacks, a lot of them.
Good, very good.
My pleasure.
Well, if it's pleasure you're after, there is one other. This farmer preacher fellow I met in Valentine, Mr. Downs.
The opinionated little do-gooder? Yeah, I know the one. I certainly know the type.
Thank you, Herr Morgan.
There's no need to thank me. Like you said, it's pleasure I'm after.
He's more slippery than he seems. I've tried being polite. Don't take any nonsense.
Nonsense? Me?
If he doesn't have the money, beat him.
Well, I usually do.
I know. I know.
Careful not to work yourself to death there, Uncle.
I was thinking.
Yeah, does it pay well?
Eventually.
So, while the rest of us are busy stealing, killing, lying, fighting to try to survive, you get to think all day.
Well, it's a strange world we live in, Arthur Morgan.
Do you want to head into town? See if we can find anything out?
Sure. I got some errands to run.
Great. Go check the horses are ready.
You gonna take the old man into town? You take us too?
Well, what you got planned?
Nothing. We'll find something for y'all to do. We always do.
We're bored out of our minds. Been cooped up here for 2 weeks now. Karen's about ready to murder Grimshaw.
Well, can Miss Grimshaw spare you?
Can Miss Grimshaw spare you? What's happened to you, Arthur? 3 young, healthy women want you to take them a robin. You're worried about house chores. Let's go.
Fair enough. You got me. Come on in.
I can't believe we're going to see civilization. Feels like weeks since we did.
Yeah, Valentine.
Very embodiment. Let's go.
All right. You know the way?
Yeah. Me and the boys got into a bit of a fight at the saloon there.
Already?
Ooh, so all that talk about how hard you've been working. You mean drinking.
Down there no more than the blue horse laying outside her door.
one of you gonna get that fella's horse?
Well, I got lumbago. It's very serious.
All right, I'll see what's going on.
Lumbago, really?
Here you go.
You're a gentleman, sir. A gentleman.
No, not really. I was just trying to impress the women.
Well, anyway, thank you.
There, boy.
Like a decent little town.
Other people, finally.
Look at all that snow on the mountains. I sure don't want to be back up there.
You think we should have asked Molly to come with us?
Oh, no. Miss O'Shea is far too high and mighty now for the likes of us, or to do any real work. She's a society lady now.
Dare's always on the right. Sure you can pick up some bounties there, Arthur.
Heaven forbid you put your head on the line.
Yeah, that's a young man's game.
Ooh, yes. We can get up to some mischief here, all right.
Just remember, keep a low profile.
Will you remember that, though, Arthur?
Probably not.
Let's park up down the end there, near the stables.
What is wrong with you?
All right. Here we are, just like I said. The cultural center of civilization. Man at his finest.
Uncle, what are we doing?
Well, we're gonna do what any self-respecting maniac does. Put the women to work.
With pleasure. We'll start at the saloon.
Okay, just stay out of trouble. Don't get yourselves noticed.
Right, I need to get something from the stores.
Okay, well, we'll see you at the general store when you're done.
Come on, ladies. Imagine we're in Paris.
Come on.
Imagine Paris and Valentine.
So that's how you see yourself, is it? A maniac?
Well, in my youth, I used to be known as the one-shot kid.
Okay. I'm not gonna ask why.
You are a sad man, Arthur Morgan. But I know you love me.
Desperately. You're my favorite parasite. No. Ringworm's my favorite parasite. You're my second favorite parasite.
Very funny.
I lied. Ringworm? Then, rats with the plague. Then you.
Shut up. This is the place, huh? Come on.
Morning.
So, what do you need?
Drop of whiskey for a start. Something to pass the time while we're waiting on the women.
Yeah. Reckon I should probably steer clear of the saloon this time.
You're looking a bit tired there, Arthur. Why don't you pick up some coffee while we're here?
Let me know if you have any questions, fellas. Whiskey's on the top shelf, nearest the door. Wait. Ain't you the fella who had the fight with Tommy outside the saloon?
Yeah, that all got a little out of hand, but I didn't swing first.
Sure, well, these things happen. And that was some good viewing. Don't reckon folk ever seen Tommy lose a fight before.
Well, it's all done now.
You not getting anything, Arthur?
I don't know. Maybe.
What do you reckon? The lamb or the sausage?
Well, this here's a sheep town. The lamb's the best in the state.
Okay, if you're done, I'll meet you outside. I won't be too long.
So, you're actually buying for once? Are you feeling all right?
See this? Young folk got no respect for their elders no more.
It's all done.
Thank you kindly. Ah, this should do the trick.
Yep, that's fine whiskey.
That should do us. Let's go wait for them outside.
All the best, fellers. Trying to stay out of trouble now.
Oh, here's to your good health, sir. And to being down here off that mountain.
Absolutely.
Get your hands off me.
You thought I wouldn't find you, Tilly.
You can go kiss a damn snake for all I care. Get off me. Get off of me.
My wife claims a ghost been stealing.
Get your hands off of her. Who are you?
A friend of mine.
Get the hell off of her, you son of a bitch.
Hey. Hey, take it easy. There's no problem here.
There will be if you don't get out of here right now.
You're making a big mistake, Tilly Jackson.
Just get lost.
I ain't doing this with you right now.
Go wait with Uncle and Mary Beth. They're across the street.
Okay. Thanks, Arthur.
Can I help you, sir?
I'm looking for a girl who came in here earlier with a drunk fella. Mid-20s, blonde. You'd remember her.
Yeah, they're in 2B upstairs. Are you, a friend of his?
A friend of hers.
No trouble now, please!
Friend of hers.
Get out of here, buddy. I paid.
Ain't paid a hitter, you goddamn animal. Come here. Who's talking now, huh? What the hell are you doing here?
Trying to play him. Not very well.
You okay?
Fine.
You sure?
Yeah. Nothing to worry about. Just men. But stupid bastard. Stupid bastard was boasting about the bank.
Bank?
Sure, I know small town banks are usually a waste of time, but this is a livestock town. There's lots of cash sometimes.
Okay. Keep investigating.
I will.
I hope everything's okay up there.
After you. Thank you, Arthur. I don't much like being saved, but when I have to be.
I understand.
You okay? Sure. He only punched me. Arthur punched him a lot harder.
Yeah. All right, then.
Just a word. Yeah!
Just borrowing it.
You stay away from me!
Get back here right now! Are you telling lies about me?
No, no. I got it wrong, partner. I got it very wrong. Now, please help me up.
I ain't never been in Blackwater.
Then why are you chasing me?
I've got an unfortunate face.
Yes, yes, me too. Now, please pull me up. Please. Please.
All right, come on. You okay, partner?
No. No, I am not. I'm a mess.
Well, you ain't dead.
There is that. Jimmy Brooks.
I think it's best for both of us if we pretend this never happened.
Well, I agree. You saved my life. You're a good man, and I, here. You want a pen? It's one of them steel ones.
Oh. That's very kind of you. But I'm not a good man, Jimmy Brooks. Not usually. You see, I was in Blackwater. I kill people. And maybe I should have killed you. Should I have killed you, Jimmy Brooks?
Me? I never saw you. Not now, not never. I think we have an understanding.
Of course we do. Jimmy Brooks. I will remember that. I've got a good memory.
I haven't. Not one lick. Not one cent in this here old mind. Come on. Come on. You have a nice day now, sir.
Appreciate you stepping in there. Those bastards been turning the screw on me from day one, saying I gotta pay them protection money. I told him where to stick it, and well, I guess you just saw how that panned out.
You watch yourself, all right?
Hey, watch it.
I've ever had. We're with you on that. Yep.
Shoot the fool!
Time to go, boy.
Whatever do you want?
Mr. Thomas Downs? You owe me money.
Oh, no, no. I'm...
Oh, come here, you maggot.
Please, sir.
Really? Threaten me, would you?
Please. I have a family, sir. Please.
I don't care about your family. Why'd it have to come to this, huh?
Believe me, sir. Believe me, sir. A little patience is all I require.
If I'm here, there's a reason I'm here. You ain't such a do-gooder, are you? If you're running out on debts...
I'm not running anywhere.
Your dad's caught you, mister. And it ain't letting go. You borrowed money from my business partner, Herr Strauss. You owe him, you took the money. He wants it back, what's not to understand? Where's our money?
I don't have it.
Sell your place.
We already owe more than it's worth.
Then sell your wife, or your family, or something. We ain't your idea of charity. Is that clear?
Thomas!
What are you looking at?
Thomas!
I said, what you looking at, woman?
My husband isn't well. If we could just have more...
Like I said, we ain't nobody's idea of charity. Get us the money.
how did you get on?
Not so good. He's almost dead. And they seem more or less destitute. You were a fool for lending them the money.
Well, people who aren't desperate don't seem so interested in my propositions.
Of course.
Miss Roberts.
Gentlemen,
have a seat.
Hiya.
Well, I suppose I should try to clear my head.
Mr. Morgan.
Reverend,
I just want to thank you for saving my life. The liquor is not my friend. Mr. Morgan, it really isn't. I make such a fool of myself.
Don't worry about it.
You're a fine man.
Now, lying on the other hand, it really is a sin.
Arthur, stop pretending to look busy and sit down.
Yeah, you got that down to a fine art.
You busy, Arthur?
Not too busy. Why?
I heard about a house. It could be interesting.
What kind of a house?
I don't know. A couple fellas I heard in town, they said it was really freakish. A family local boogeyman, I guess. But they're crooked in every way.
So?
Well, so these boys thought they were sitting on a lot of cash. They're highway robbers, kidnappers, apparently. They're well hidden in the woods.
That sounds pretty dubious.
Of course. It's dubious, but there ain't much risk of getting caught.
Okay, then. Let's go take a look.
Exactly. Just take a look.
Hey, fella.
pretty close now. Let's stop and go on foot from here. Just up the hill this way. Follow me. There's a spot up ahead where we should be able to get a good look at the place. I want to make sure we don't run into any surprises.
Sure.
Apparently, this family's been isolated for so long, they started talking in their own weird dialect. They really don't like outsiders, especially on their turf.
Well, you just keep selling me on this job, don't you?
Oh, big place, right?
Well, there's a pretty big barn in the back. It's not a bad place to start looking. There must be a lot of people living here. A large house.
Stash could be in any one of them buildings, and who knows how many people are in there. I ain't sure about this.
I think we need to draw them out somehow. I got an idea. Follow me.
All these trees, I can't get a proper look at the place.
Well, hopefully it'll make it harder for them to spot us, too.
Coast seems clear so far.
Yeah, so far.
Hey, keep it down. I hear voices. Come on, let's hide behind this shed. See if we can hear what they're saying. Stay low, Arthur. Just stay quiet.
Where you been now, noob? Don't be boiling now, Pappy. I's gone but 10 minutes I was.
Come hollygag all the now day long, cause Edie takes patrol now, don't you?
What? Oh, Edie, get all the jam!
You shut your gulper, or I'll flagger your felt, I will. Your niece will pull it up, boy. Up. Go guard the shed.
Go!
You understand what they're saying?
Not much of it. What are we doing, Javier?
Okay, you take cover by the rock over there. I'll create a little distraction, and then you jump them, okay?
What kind of distraction?
You'll see.
Be quiet.
Thank you.
Has to be under here. There's no place else I could store it. Hey, Arthur. Give me a hand here. I told you it was worth the trouble, didn't I?
Yeah. You take this. Let's split up. I'll meet you back at camp.
Sounds good.
Leave me be. Okay, okay. Your secret's safe with me.
Hey! Untie me, damn it!
Well, I'll know where to find you.
Please, God, no!
Okay.
Whoa, back.
Hey there.
Yeah.
Again, good to see you again. We're moving along slowly, but less than surely. I got more chance of teaching a pig to sing opera than to turn this pair into carpenters.
You don't look so bad to me.
I asked God for sons, and he sent me donkeys. Ain't that right, boys?
Crappy piece of land? Stop taking our stuff, damn it! Right from under my nose, you bastard! I never wanted to be here in the first place.
Well, don't let me keep you.
Easy, easy. Yep.
Good shooting, senor. Thank God for you, mister. Le debo la vida.
Good luck with it.
Que alivio.
Yeah.
You're back.
You all right there, boy?
Hearing him. Oh, my balls!
Mr. Morgan.
How are you doing?
I can't complain.
Hey, Sean.
Well, I can.
Good. We really needed this.
In Lincolnshire, my daddies were outside Rotterdam. At least that's what they told me. The modern world is ugly.
Thank you, Arthur. Hey, if you could give me some leatherworking tools, I could make some rugs and blankets and the like out of these hides you're bringing in.
All right, I'll see what I can do. Appreciate it, Pearson.
With hope and dreams. Seriously. And that hope begins now by being hopeful. And happy. So cheer up.
Dear Arthur, I've written this letter 100 times or more, and I cannot get it right. It's me. You know it's me from the bad handwriting. I know I said when we last spoke, and I was going off to get married, that we would not speak again. I know I said a lot of things, and I meant them, I suppose, at the time. But I'm not so proud as to not speak to people who care for me, or cared for me. I've been in Valentine for a couple of months. I had some bad luck, and, well, it's a long story and not an interesting one. But I am here for now. I saw a couple of the girls, or whatever the polite term is for them, that ran with you and your associates in town. And I heard tell of a man who sounded like you. I would love to see you again. If you could spare me a little bit of your time. I'm renting a room at Chadwick Farm, just north of Valentine. Yours, Mary Linton.
with the goddamn Philippines? Who cares about the Philippines? What even are the Philippines? Just the biggest load of nonsense yet. God. Yeah, it's enough to turn a good, honest fella to drink. Being a bad, dishonest fella, it's gonna send me to drink twice as fast. I just can't cope. Really. I can't.
Lenny?
Hey, Arthur.
That knife's sharp enough, ain't it?
Depends. Why? You feel lucky?
Do you?
Oh, before me, at least 6 generations were born in chains. And for the last 3 years, I've been running from every lawman and bounty hunter west of the Lanahassee River. So yeah, I feel lucky. I'm the living embodiment of luck.
That is one way of seeing things.
But I'm also skill. And in this game, you got to have luck and skill.
And stupidity.
The Outlaw's Trinity. Luck, skill, and just a dose of stupidity. Come on. You ain't too old and too slow just yet.
After you.
As you wish. You know, we should head back up that mountain sometime and make Jenny a proper grave. Something nice.
Let's go, boy.
A hole starts to taste the zing, doesn't it? I know. Pearson has an unusual talent for removing all flavor.
Thank you.
Look at what we snagged! Dutchie's dogs, buddy! I told you he'd show! All right, boys, let's introduce ourselves.
Got a problem? What is it?
What are you doing back here?
Ain't you caused enough trouble?
Huh? Beating up half the saloon like that? Near killing Tommy out in the street?
Keep your opinions to yourself. You're next, okay?
Don't fellas like you ever get bored of pushing folk around?
Get your head out of your ass. Your friend had worse coming. I let him off easy.
Leave me alone. Back off.
What?
Step right up,
Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to disturb you, ma'am. Is Mrs. Linton in?
I'll go see.
Mrs. Linton, a caller for you.
Hello, Arthur.
Mary?
I heard you and your friends was around.
Okay. Where's what's his name?
Died.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, me too. Me too. Happened a while ago. Pneumonia.
Bad business.
Sure.
So, you've been made a widow and you come here looking for me, is that it?
No, ain't like that, Arthur.
Ah, okay.
Listen, Arthur, my family. I need your help.
You mean the family that always looked down on me? You want me to help?
It's my little brother, Jamie.
I always liked Jamie, at least compared to the rest of them.
He's broken Daddy's heart.
Daddy has a heart?
Don't make me beg you, Arthur.
My money, my life, me. I wasn't good enough.
I'm sorry. We need your help real bad. Little Jamie's joined the Chelonians, that strange religious order.
Good for him.
They're quite mad, Arthur. They'll kill him. You're the only person he'd listen to.
So, I'm too rough to marry into your family, but it's okay to ask me to help in saving your family.
I'm sorry. I understand if you don't want to help me, but I think of you often.
Long time ago now.
I'm begging you, Arthur.
I say let Jamie live Jamie's life and not the nightmare that his daddy dreamed up for him.
Jamie's so innocent, Arthur. Please, Arthur. Will you help me?
Where is it?
Somewhere out near Carmody Dell, I think. The rancher there said he'd seen him around the Cumberland Forest. I just want him back, Arthur. If you find him, bring him to me at the station.
I'll see what I can do.
I'll owe you.
You already owe me.